Black History Month ended a couple hours ago, and there are people who would kind of like to see it go away permanently. Now, I gotta admit, on a certain level, I kind of would like to see it go away too, but not for the reasons that most people who hold this opinion have. Actress Stacey Dash a couple of years ago had expressed the sentiment that we can either have integration or segregation, and if we're going to have integration, then we need to do away with artifices such as Black History Month, BET, Source Awards, Image Awards, and so forth, these kind of black-only or black-centric events. And then she went on further to say that if the role were reversed, that everyone would be up in arms. Yeah, let's talk about that. The thing Miss Dash doesn't seem to understand is Black History Month isn't what we wanted, it's what we could get. So first we need to take a look at where Black History Month came from. So, in the 20s, a black historian named Clark Woodson had suggested that perhaps it would be a good idea to have a week to commemorate achievements of black people and kind of share the history of black people in America. He felt that this would be a way to tie the community together, particularly in the antebellum South. Now he was met with quite a bit of opposition, but eventually he was able to get enough people to get on board with this to make it happen. You have to understand that in Mr. Woodson's time, the history of black people in America generally wasn't being taught. If it was taught, it was generally taught from the perspective of slavery and the Civil War. But in the antebellum South in particular, even that wasn't taught, or if it was being taught, it was distorted in a lot of ways. This is when the myth of the Lost Cause was being built. This is when slavery as a root cause of the Civil War was being minimized, or people were just outright lying about it and saying that it wasn't the case. So in this context, you understand Mr. Woodson felt that if we had a week to reflect and learn about the accomplishments of black history, a complete a history of black people in America, the good things and the bad things, that this would be inspirational, this would be motivational, this could bring the community together. And so what started off as a week, later in the 70s was expanded to a month by professors at Kent State, where this was initiated and eventually spread out elsewhere. So why would I want Black History Month to go away? Clearly, I care about black history. My reasons are that I do want things to be integrated. I want the history of black people to be included in regular history class because the history of black people in America is also American history and should be taught as such. All Americans should know about the Tuskegee Airmen and the Tuskegee Experiment. Americans shouldn't only know Martin Luther King, George Washington Carver, and Jackie Robinson. They should also know Marcus Garvey, Shirley Chisholm, and Larry Doby. They should know Crispus Attucks as well as Nathan Hale. They should know Guy Bluford as well as Alan Shepard. And they should know Vernon Baker as well as Creighton Abrams. Creighton Abrams has a tank named after him. You've never heard of Vernon Baker. I'll be most happy when the Buffalo Soldiers are taught alongside and equal to Rogers Rangers. Now, some people have challenged me and said, well, how come we don't have a Hispanic History Month? And the thing is, I'm perfectly fine with having that. Although, again, I'd like to have the accomplishments of Hispanic Americans, be they Latinos, Chicanos, Mestizos, and others, taught alongside history with everybody else, because their story is an American story. And for those that are constantly haranguing about the fact that there's no White History Month, I think most of us understand that that's generally March through January. And an interesting little tidbit I'd love to throw at the people who are so aggrieved about the fact that Black History Month exists. Take a little bit of math here. February is 1 month out of 12, 8.3%. But February is also the shortest month, So it's 28 days out of 365. That's only 7.7% of the days of the year. But we'll average that out and we'll say it's about 8%. Well, even there, we're being underrepresented. Blacks are 13.3% of the population as of when I'm doing this video. Another interesting little math fact. If you take 8% divided by 13.3%, you get around 0.6. So it means we're getting 60% of the representation that we should get if the history class represented all the population numerically. Interesting thing about 60%. So even in history months, we're still only counted as three-fifths of a man. Think about that the next time you're opining about No White History Month. So back to Stacey Dash's point from the beginning of the video, I'd gladly trade Black History Month if we could be integrated in the rest of the year. But I bet we'd probably get quite a bit of resistance. If we didn't have Black History Month, we'd have nothing at all. So as long as that's the case, it's not what I'd want, but it's what I can get, and I'll take it.